Hi guys, this is Maduba John from MJC Designs. In today's lesson, we are going to look at how to correct mapping in Photoshop and apply in 3ds Max. So let's get started. Some of us will normally have the problem of mapping in 3ds Max. I'm going to show you the kind of problem we normally have when mapping our floor. So I'm going to apply a material on this floor. Let's say I want to apply this map, this asphalt. As you can see, we can see the lines. This is not what we want. And I know some of us normally have this problem. The method we are going to use to correct it is on Photoshop. We are going to correct it on Photoshop before we apply again on 3ds Max. So I'm going to take you to Photoshop now and then drag this here. I want to try to correct the map because it looks like one place is kind of dark. This place here is dark while the other place is lighter, and this is the reason why we have this this line here in 3ds Max. So we are going to correct in Photoshop. So the first thing I'm going to do is duplicate this so that any correction I did, or if I want to go back to the original image, I can easily go back. So you have to duplicate it first. You just drag it and put here, duplicate it. Okay, so we are going to try to correct this. So let's go to our filter, order and offset. So you're going to see the problem here, where the problem started. Okay, try to adjust it to make it, to make this thing at our center, to make it come to our center. This line here, you can see this line. Okay, so that's how I want to correct it. Then you press OK. So the next thing we do is we try to, you know, clone this material here to erase this part so that everything will look like a seamless texture. So we go come to our tool here, clone tool. Okay, so we are going to copy this by pressing our Alt key down to copy. Then you click, you press our Alt key down and click to capture that side. Okay, so I'm going to make our brush a little bit soft because it's kind of hard. Put it here, hard, just release the hardness here, it's kind of hard. So I'm going to brush it and erase it. I'm going to capture it again, brush and erase. Capture brush. This is just what you're going to do to erase this, that thing you don't want to see. Okay, so I'm going to try to increase my brush capture. Okay, this is fine. So let's try to, you know, do it one more time. This time we're going to make our brush a little harder. Okay, fine. So now we have corrected it. We have to try to apply it all over again to see if that thing has been corrected. Okay, so we're going to save as, try to save as so you don't overwrite your original material in case of you want to do it again, so you don't spoil your original material. Okay, so I've saved it all over again. So this is my new This is my new texture. This is my old one. You can see this place is kind of dark. So we are going to apply it all over again. Okay. I drag and place in here. As you can see, it has been corrected. So there's no longer, we don't have those lines you have there. This is just fine. So this is the simplest way how to correct. You know, the knowledge of Photoshop and 3ds Max, you can't, it goes hand in hand. You can't know 3ds Max completely without the knowledge of Photoshop. These things, especially this Photoshop, it helps you to get a good texture in 3ds Max. It is just so important for 3ds Max knowledge. You have to know Photoshop. So I've been taking some people tutorials on how to, you know, improve on their 3D visualization. So if you're interested, just hit my email. Okay, so this is it. I'm going to try to put the old one before, so you see the difference. Okay, as you can see the lines. Okay, this is the lines, what we don't want. Okay, what we don't want in our texture. So I'm going to put the corrected one, and this is it. This is fine. You know, when you do these things, it gives you realistic texture. Okay, we don't have to get maps, you know, only irregular maps on our floor and all that. This is just how to correct it. So thanks guys for watching. Share to your friends, you know, subscribe, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to go to my Facebook page, and you can like too. You can follow some of my renderings, and I'll be posting my tutorial there too, so you can follow it. And you can also subscribe, turn on your notification button, so anytime I make out tutorial, you can easily see the notification. So that's gonna be it, and thank you for watching. I still remain Maduba John from MJC Designs. So I've been quite busy lately, so that's why I've not been able to do one or two tutorials. So, but I'm back, not fully though, but I'm back. I'm going to try to, you know, create time to do this more. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to share, don't forget to like, and then if you think this has helped you, just comment in the comment box. And don't forget to give me thumbs up if you like it. So this is it. So try to communicate with me so that I can, you know,